Alright y'all, what is going on? Right now I'm trying to get some bait, some small finger mullet just like that, because we are going to go try to catch some tarpon and some snook in some backwater areas. On land today, it's pretty windy out, so I'm just going to go on land. But first, we got to get some bait. Alright, we got the live mullet as you saw. Sorry if the lens is acting kind of different or is acting weird. Condensation is fogging up. It's 90 degrees out right now, so it is very hot. But we got some live mullet, perfect size ones like that big. We're going to be going around land here in some of my land spots, like I said when I was going to get bait. We're targeting snook, tarpon, redfish, big trout, basically whatever bites. Sorry if I'm not as energetic as I usually am. I am feeling a bit under the weather right now. Getting over a little cold, so I'm still trying to get a lot of my energy and my strength back. So I'm just kind of slowly going with the flow. Gonna go around these spots right now, hopefully try to get out of the wind, and I'll pick up the camera when I'm at my first spot. First spot. Just gonna grab a mullet here. See what happens. There's a fish. What is this? What is this? It's a tarpon, the good little tarpon. Look at that. How about that? Come here, buddy. It's a good tarpon for back here. Holy crap. Holy cow. That's what I like to see right there. Holy cow. First mullet in. Come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. Yes, I thought it was a snook, but no, it's a tarpon. This is a good tarpon, like I said, for back here. Come here, buddy. Hooked perfectly in the corner of the mouth. Oh shoot. This might be a little bit difficult here. Come on, buddy. He's not giving up, man. He is not giving up. Come on, dude. Just give up. Here we go. Here we go. No. Oh, there he goes. Hook just popped out right there. I'll take that. Looks like we got fish busting over here. Oh. Oh, one got it and came off with. Oh boy, that was sick. Let me retie. Let's try that again. The thing is, you don't want them to eat it long, because if you eat it, let them eat it long, they possibly can just take you in the trees over there. There's a fish. Oh! That was a snook right there. Dang it! Just broke the line. There's a fish. Get him out of there. Get him out. Get him out. I got him, so I don't know how I still have him. But I got him. There we go. He's out. There you go. I don't know how I still have this fish, but I still got him. It's a tarpon. I see him. Thing is, I can't get in the water. Oh! Broke off. That was a snook. That was a snook that just ate the mullet right there. There's a couple of them. Oh, tarpon's after him. Tarpon's got him. Oh, he missed him. He missed him. Come on, come back. Come back. After him, it's a tarpon. He got it. Oh my god, he missed it. It's hard to set the hook with these, or it's hard to reel with all this stuff right here, all the structure. It's hard, man, when you're close quarter fishing like this and then you have all these trees and everything. It's so hard to get the proper like hook set or something, you know what I mean? Fish usually like to eat right before a storm and after, especially snook and tarpon. So I'm hoping we can maybe capitalize here before it actually starts raining pretty hard. There's a fish. Snook. Snook, snook, snook. Come here. Oh my gosh, look at that. Oh yes. That was awesome. He's not a big one, but heck yes. Dude. All right, y'all, so check this out. It's a nice little snook. He has two hooks in him. I lost this fish a minute ago because that's my hook where he broke off. And That's the hook that's on my line, right? My reel right now. All right, we're gonna let him go because he seems to be ready. There you go, buddy. That was awesome.